Immediately after winning the Iowa caucus and solidifying his status as the likely GOP nominee for president, Donald Trump was back in a courtroom for a defamation trial where his lawyer was scolded by the judge for being very bad at her job. For more on this, it's time for Closer Look. Well, as predicted, Donald Trump won the Iowa caucus by a large margin. This is the second time Trump has won Iowa after first winning it in 2020. But in his victory speech Monday, Trump claimed he won Iowa three times, which is not true.
This has been an incredible experience. The people have been, this is the third time we've won.
That's how much of a serial liar Trump is. He embellishes even the stuff that's good for him. It's not enough to win Iowa twice, this year with over 50% of the vote. He still has to lie to make it even bigger. He can't control himself. Trump could win an Olympic gold medal while holding a winning Powerball ticket and becoming the first man to set foot on Mars, and he'd still say, you know, I'm also taller than Victor Wembanyama. We love to say the name, don't we? Wembanyama. Trump lost the Iowa caucus in 2016 to Ted Cruz, but he probably thinks when you defeat an opponent, you also absorb their electoral victories. Trump thinks he won not just the 2016 Iowa caucus, but also most scraggly at the 2023 Beardy Awards. Now, you might not recall that when Trump lost to Cruz in 2016, he was hardly gracious in defeat, claiming there was fraud, accusing Cruz of stealing the caucus, and saying the results should be nullified. And that's what high school English teachers call foreshadowing. So Trump won Iowa decisively, although his two remaining rivals didn't seem to get the message. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, for example, finished 30 points behind Trump, but acted like he'd actually won.
I can tell you, because of your support, in spite of all of that that they threw at us, everyone against us, we've got our ticket punched out of Iowa.
Yes, that's right. By finishing a distant second, DeSantis got his ticket punched out of Iowa. Unfortunately, his ticket is for Alaska Airlines. It's an exit row, guys. This is the best thing that ever happened to Spirit Airlines. Like, they... It's been like five shows in a row we haven't even whispered their name. Second, DeSantis, when you say it like that, it sounds like you're bragging about leaving. We got our ticket punched, which means we can finally get the f*** out of Iowa. I've been trapped in this godforsaken corn maze of a state for 6 months. I can't wait to leave. They said the only way we'd crack double digits is if hell froze over, which I can tell you, the hell did freeze over, and it's still not as cold as Iowa. And then there's Nikki Haley, who came in third place behind DeSantis, but implied that the results had somehow narrowed the race down to two candidates, which I guess she thinks includes her.
I can safely say tonight, Iowa made this Republican primary a two-person race.
A two-person race? You finished third. Who aren't you counting? I don't know how to tell you this, but you just got your ticket punched back into Iowa. You're gonna get on a plane in Des Moines and land in Cedar Rapids. It's like Russian Doll, but Iowa. Now, of course, it might be a two-person race if either DeSantis or Haley drop out, but the GOP establishment is rejecting that option and instead telling them both to drop out.
You're calling on Nikki Haley and Ron DeSantis to drop out right now.
I am, and I do think that would be healthy for this country.
It's time to step aside and endorse Trump.
At this point, I believe this race is over, so I am proud to endorse Donald Trump for president of the United States. I look forward to supporting him enthusiastically.
I look forward to supporting Trump and endorsing him and also giving him my trophy for Texan most likely to bolt for Cancun in a weather crisis. I wonder if Cruz is jealous of DeSantis and Haley. Those two ran against Trump and got off relatively easy. Trump called DeSantis a meatball and floated some birther nonsense about Haley, but that's it. Back in 2016, Trump called Cruz a liar and a cheater, sicked his supporters on Cruz, insulted his wife's appearance, and claimed his dad killed JFK. Cruz must be like, oh, what the hell? Why can't you spread some rumors about DeSantis? Say his hair is fake, or his grandpa killed Abraham Lincoln, or stole his white go-go boots from the fembots in Austin Powers? I have to say, it is really fun to come up with fake Trump rumors about other people. You know, Ron likes to fight Disney, but not many people know he got his start as one of the dolls, and it's a small world after all. He only hates Disney because without his boots, he's not allowed on any of the rides. In fact, the indignities never seem to end for Cruz because in that same interview, The Fox host Sean Hannity discussed Cruz's own reelection campaign and described him this way to his face.
Every time you run for reelection, you are maybe the second most hated man behind Donald Trump in politics.
I actually think people hate Ted Cruz more because here's the tiebreaker. Ted Cruz likes Donald Trump, and Donald Trump hates Ted Cruz. That, by the way, that's a friendly interview on Fox News, and even they're openly insulting Cruz to his face. In fact, later in that interview, the Chiron below him just said, holy this guy sucks. Now, I do think it's worth pointing out that Trump's apparent blowout win on Iowa is actually very hollow. Yes, he won 51% of the caucus vote, but only 15% of Iowa Republicans, who themselves only make up about a third of the small state's electorate, came out to the caucus. And of that small slice of the electorate, 49% voted for someone other than Trump, which means Trump got fewer than 57,000 votes. On top of that, 32% of Iowa Republican caucus goers said Trump would not be fit to be president if he's convicted in one of his four criminal cases. And you have to remember, these are among the most hardcore Republican voters in the country, people who showed up not just to a polling booth, but to a caucus, which takes a while, in Iowa, in the ass crack of January, with wind chills that fell to below 30 degrees in what experts say was the coldest Iowa caucus on record. I didn't even think I would haul my ass out to vote against Trump in weather like that. I'd be at home in front of a fire, sipping a hot toddy, and making a list of countries with open 12:30 time slots. If Trump wins in November, tune into my new Japanese talk show, Most Honorable Comedy Discussion Hour. The fun part, every time a joke bombs on my new show, I get hit in the nuts, just like the contestants on this very real game show. Now, there's a guy who got his
ticket punched.
Anyway, politics. As we've said many times on the show, Donald Trump still is, and has always been, deeply unpopular. And now he's also facing a mountain of legal woes. The day after his win in Iowa, Trump appeared in a Manhattan courtroom for the defamation suit brought by E. Jean Carroll. You know, after each of his election wins, they should interview Trump like those old Disney World commercials. You just won Iowa by a historic margin. What are you going to do next? I'm going to New York to stand trial for defamation. Once in the courtroom, Trump made it clear he wasn't happy to be there, but also seemed confused about what was happening.
Jurors heard opening statements Tuesday in another case relating to former President Donald Trump's sexual assault and defamation of E. Jean Carroll.
The former president was seen in a New York courtroom sort of shaking his head recently when the judge basically said that he was found guilty for sexually abusing Carroll back in the 1990s.
As for former President Trump, he was taking a very good look at prospective jurors. One of the questions Judge Kaplan asked to the jurors was, is there anybody here who thinks former President Trump has been treated unfairly?
Donald Trump, fresh off a victory in Iowa, then sitting at a defense table today, raising his hand when the judge asked if anyone felt the former president had been treated unfairly by the court system.
The judge asked prospective jurors if anyone felt Trump had been treated unfairly, and Trump himself raised his hand. This dude always thinks people are talking to him. I bet at his wedding, he talked after the priest said, speak now or forever hold your peace.
I'll say a few words. I'm gonna go through with the wedding, but I do have some concerns. It's my third one. Sometimes I think I'm unlucky in love. I can tell from Melania's face that she's a little mad I'm talking, or she's not mad, and her face always looks like that. I guess I'll find out. I guess I'll find out once we're married. I guess we should get on with it now.
You think that after four indictments, two impeachments, a fraud trial, thousands of lawsuits, and hundreds of episodes of Law and Order, Trump would know how the criminal justice system works by now. And yet, somehow, Donald Trump is not the only one on the Trump side who has no idea how any of this works. His attorney, Alina Haba, has been scolded in court by the judge for repeatedly asking for the trial to be adjourned after that request was already rejected. Basically, Trump's team wants the case adjourned so Trump can attend his mother-in-law's funeral. But Trump is not required to attend the trial. He doesn't have to be there, so there's no reason to adjourn. He can just go and do what he wants. The judge keeps repeating that, and Trump's lawyers keep asking anyway, because they're just trying to delay the trial and create conflict for political purposes. And that has led to multiple tense exchanges in the courtroom.
Now, they previously asked if the whole case could be pushed back because of this funeral. That was denied. But she brought it up today and modified her request. She said instead, can we just not have court on Thursday so he can attend a funeral? The judge didn't seem to like that she was bringing this up again, reminded her that she already got an answer and said no. He doesn't have any need to be there every day. He doesn't have a role, and if he wants to testify, he can do so on Monday.
Judge Kaplan quickly denied the application and said he will have no further argument on the matter. And when Ms. Haba tried to speak again, he told her to sit down and to follow his rules.
She responded, "I don't like to be spoken to that way." The judge repeated, "Sit down. Your objection is not merited. Sit down."
Damn, I didn't think it was possible for Trump to find a worse lawyer than Rudy Giuliani, but he did it. Fun fact, now that Rudy is no longer Trump's lawyer, he's become a contestant on Japanese game shows. I didn't feel a thing! Bring on the speed round! These people think they can just say and do whatever they want without consequences, but they're waking up to the harsh reality that courtrooms have rules and judges enforce those rules. It doesn't matter if 51% of the 15% of Iowa Republicans who have good winter coats just voted for you in a high school gymnasium. When you're in court, you have to follow the rules and listen to the judge. Otherwise, you'll be disbarred and end up on a Japanese game show getting your
ticket punched.
This has been A Closer Look. Hey, everybody, thanks for watching A Closer Look. And as a reminder, my brother Josh and I have started a new podcast called Family Trips with the Meyers Brothers. We hope you listen. We hope you like it. And see you soon.